Hello, Internet! It's Monday again! Don't worry, I brought you a movie! Today on Movie Monday, I bring you Bloodfather. Jean-Francois Richette brings us this crime drama with some action elements about an ex-con, ex-drug addict, ex-enforcer, ex-gang member called Link, who is trying to clean up his act and live a normal life when out of nowhere his daughter contacts him for help because she is in some deep trouble. The movie starts by introducing us to the daughter, who is rolling with some seriously shady guys. It is quickly established that the girl is not in a fun place in her life. It's safe to say she's in shit, and by shit I don't mean my period is late or my boyfriend cheated on me or I totaled mom's car. No. She's in, I think I killed a guy, so his friends hunt me. Also, I do a lot of drugs. And did I mention I killed a guy kind of shit? So, to make up for past wrongs, Link tries to help her daughter the best way he can. But the bad guys soon find them, so they have to go on the run from them and the police. From there on, it's a road trip movie with character building and some action elements. You might say this is a typical B-movie, we have seen dozens. But it's not like any other movie, thanks to the acting and realistic portrayal of addiction and elements of the criminal lifestyle. Mel Gibson delivers a solid performance as the lead. The premise is interesting as it is. How do you make up for lost time with your daughter, who as you did goes through hell? And how can you help her? Gibson shines in this role, proving once again that he's a great actor. Aaron Moriarty plays... Wait, Moriarty? Like in Sherlock Holmes? How are you not a supervillain with that name? Anyway, she portrays the messed up teenager really well, despite the fact that she has not much movie experience. William H. Macy is, as always, a good side character, and Diego Luna is also good in the movie. The movie is more a drama than an action movie, but it has sweet action in it, sometimes very graphic ones as well. The way the movie was shot gives you a low budget vibe, but it also makes it feel realistic. There are no grand spectacles in this movie, but you will enjoy it nonetheless. I will give this movie an 8. You know what? No. Gibson's portrayal alone deserves that, so a 9 out of 10. The movie is really grounded and overall well told. It is a shame that not a lot of cinemas played this movie. If you can bring it home, definitely watch it on Blu-ray, DVD or on Netflix. I will leave a link to the trailer down below. Have you seen this movie? What did you think of it? What do you think? What is the best performance from Mel Gibson out there? Leave your answers in the comment section down below. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and for more content like this, feel free to subscribe. And as always, thank you for watching.